Well, good evening and welcome along to Loughborough University here at the Netball and Badminton Centre. It's been a, quite frankly, lovely day. The sun has been shining. Well, the luck will be shining down on East London Phoenix this evening as they take on an undefeated and champions-elect in Loughborough Lightning. Both of them have already booked their places into the playoffs at the end of the regular season. But can they end this season on a high? This is East London Phoenix's last game of the regular season, with Loughborough Lightning having one more game coming up after this in, I believe, the 5th of May, where they'll be taking on Worcester Wolves. Well, I'm your commentator, Elliot Stockton. It's an absolute pleasure to be here for today's game. We've got a couple of really exciting teams in action. The two top goal scorers in the league in terms of point scoring. And it's quite an exciting prospect, really, that we have on show here for both sides. Loughborough Lightning have come into this with some fantastic form, as I was alluding to a few moments ago, with that undefeated run. But East London Phoenix have only won 3 games a season, losing 3 as well. So they've been ever so slightly inconsistent. But the teams are just getting prepared now to come out of the tunnels, with tip-off at 6 o'clock.
OK, first of all, George, congratulations. 3 seasons in a row, 3 titles. You must be happy overall.
Yeah, we're really pleased. Obviously, we've not lost a game yet this year, but the big playoff final is in May, so that's what we're really focusing on. With basketball, the league doesn't really matter so much. The big thing is winning the playoffs, so that's what we're fully focused on.
And you touched on there that it's another unbeaten season so far. How are you preparing for this game against a tough London Phoenix side?
Yeah, well, we've been working hard. They scored 92, I think, or 93 a couple of weeks ago. So they've got a really efficient scoring output. So we've worked really hard and we're under kind of no illusions that this is going to be an easy game. We think it's going to be a real battle and kind of go to the wire a little bit. And hopefully we can go out there and use the stuff that we've been working on.
And you've got Siobhan Fitzpatrick back for the first time this season. How is she feeling ahead of today's game?
I think she's really excited. So she's been on the sideline since the Europeans, which were in September last year. So it's been a long, long old process for her to get back. So I'm really excited that she's back in the squad, and I know she's super excited to be back on a basketball court again.
Fantastic. Best of luck for today.
Thank you.
OK, well, welcome along to Loughborough. This is your final game of the season. Just in a quick summary, give us how the season's gone so far for you.
The season has gone well for us. Obviously, like any season, it's been up and down. We've had some good moments, some challenging moments, but you know, it's good for us going to the last game of the season, and we already got our place secure in the playoffs. So I think it's gone as well as it could have gone.
And how are the players feeling ahead of those playoffs that are coming up?
I think the players we're in a good place. I think we're where we need to be. You know, we've had a couple of injuries, you know, we're down to, you know, we lost a couple of players along the way. But I think in terms of confidence, I think we're exactly where I thought we would be at this point of the season.
And you're coming up against today the league champions in Loughborough Lightning for the 3rd season in a row. How tough of a game is that going to be for your players today?
Yeah, it's obviously the toughest game of the season, you know, I think for both teams. You know, obviously Loughborough is the champion. And we're just trying to see how we can do, what advantage we can get, knowing we still got one more game to play. We know this is going to be a tough game. Loughborough, you know, they have a good team. They got one of the best players in the world in Bo. Obviously, we're very disappointed that we lost a couple of our players that we were hoping to sign for the season. You know, obviously, it's no fault of their own. I think if we have those players, maybe, you know, we're looking at different things to do to them. But with the player that we have got for this season, I'm very confident that we'll do the best we can. You know, we're trying to find the best version of ourselves as a team.
And finally, just looking ahead to next season, what are your plans overall? I presume, obviously, going for the title.
Obviously, you know, we want to win. We want to win this season. Obviously next season. And apart from only winning, you can describe winning all different, different ways. For us, you know, part of winning is making sure that we have a program that a player can come in and improve. And as long as we are developing good players, and that's part of winning. And then obviously, hopefully, that will translate into winning the championship. So, You know, I think we're a better team from last season. We want to keep doing that, you know, improving again next season.
Fantastic. Best of luck for today. Well, with just 60 seconds to go then, until we get off and underway here, another warm welcome to you all, wherever you're watching in the world. We've got a nice little attendance growing here at Loughborough University, as it is Loughborough Lightning who take on East London Phoenix in the penultimate game of the season for Lightning. They've already got the title wrapped up. Phoenix already wrapping up second place. This is their last game of the season. Lightning have got one more coming up on the 5th of May. The picture you're just seeing now, that is of the head coach of East London Phoenix, Ade Orogbeme. This is his second full season in charge. He took over back in September of 2022. His goal was to win the league. And while they haven't done that, he was telling me just before the game, a little pre-match interview, how not all successes are about winning on the pitch or on the court. In this instance, it's about growing that belief and growing that enjoyment and just making sure everyone's growing and developing, not just as players, but as people. So, despite the fact that they haven't won the league for the second successive year, and it is 3 years on the trot now for Loughborough Lightning, he does feel like they're making great progress in the direction that he wants his team to be pushing. Well, as for Lightning and George Bates, they're just aiming once again to go unbeaten. They'd like to do it in some impressive style. Bo Kramer is back for Loughborough Lightning, the world champion. The 24-year-old Dodgman has travelled with the squad and does start this evening. As for the visitors, East London Phoenix, Beth Wheeler is the pick of the bunch, the number 13 for her side. She does as well start this evening. Number 10, Amy Conroy, also in the side. Debbie Steele for London Phoenix too. Curran Brown, the 28-year-old Georgian. Kramer from that centre wins the ball immediately, and it is Loughborough Lightning in possession with Robin Love, who plays it back out to Kramer, who's on the offensive down that right side. Going back inside, a nice ball towards that far area with Love in possession. She'll go for a long range effort, goes in and out of the ring somehow.
It remains 0-0 in the opening 30 seconds of this game, with London Phoenix now going forward with Amy Conroy in possession. She chose to go for the basket and gets it in without any ricochets. Fantastic finish there from the 31-year-old Englishman. I love coming forward, throwing it in. Ashley Dawn. Good defensive work from London Phoenix. Finding Wheeler, who will go for Ethma. Oh, what an effort! You say she's going for it. Well, she went for it and made it. It's a fantastic, blistering start here from Phoenix against Lightning. Loving possession, finding Kramer. She's always dangerous from these positions, and that's why first points on the board in this game for the Lightning. Conroy, central position. Just waiting for Steele. Down this right side. Steele still in possession. As the klaxon goes, you can push on. 20 seconds left for them. They get 22 to get from one end of the court to the other and shoot, which Kramer does, but in the process had been fouled. Russell had gone as she was shooting, so if the point had gone in, it would have counted. So it will be Loughborough's ball from the back. The person you're seeing on the screen now, Corin Brown. She's got a bit of a technical issue with her chair at the moment, which is why we have the delay. These things can happen. The clock stopped with only a minute and 6 seconds gone. I think one of her ties has actually gone, which is what they're trying to potentially replace here, or even pump up, as you're just seeing to the left of your screen. Corin Brown, 28-year-old, from a spinal cord injury at the age of 6, and over the last 2 decades, she's built a career in wheelchair basketball, amongst many other things, and such are the inspiring stories that we do hear from during our, you know, interviews and our opportunities to talk to the players. So many of these athletes have come through so many trials and tribulations, really, to get to where they are. And you cannot fault their dedication or their drive either, something that I'm sure we all would long to have. That's fixed up from the restart, so we're back at level 2-4 apiece. Robin Love has got a league-high total average of 10 points per game, 10 assists per game, which she has in the absence of Bo Kramer, and even with Laurie Williams, who is her partner, incidentally enough, but following that return to the squad, Robin can focus more on the assist side to her game rather than the attacking shooting style that she's had to sort of adopt over the last couple of months. Now, at the first time out phase of this game, he scores a level at 4 apiece. Timeout called there from East London Phoenix, presumably due to the ongoing chair issue they have with a couple of their players, but all is well for both teams after what's been a stop start beginning to this game. Oh, It'll be Nice, London, Phoenix. But from that far side, Amy Conroy going over to it. It's a central pass. Look out towards the left wing it goes with Wheeler. She goes for a looping effort. It's the ball again. Bounces back out, and now Lightning can pounce forward on this fast and ferocious counter-attack with Kramer. Out wide, finds Love. Squeezing away in, finds Williams. Well, from my angle, that looked like it had gone in, but somehow evaded the net. And now here come Phoenix down the right. Circling around the centre now with Conroy. Finds a route to the basket and gets it in. Really good weaving play. Now Lightning need a bit of support. It's Williams finding Love. Great back pass for Kramer. Tries to use the backboard to bounce it in. Didn't quite work out the way she wanted it to there. Conroy down this right side. Inside pass just behind Brown. Count wide it goes. Steal. She can't find the back of the basket. Love. Looking for a route, looking for a way. Finding Williams. Only a few seconds left before she has to shoot. We're into the final three. She will shoot now and get it in. Again, from my angle, it looked like just clipped the bottom of the net, but she managed to angle that in well enough to give her side 2 points to get themselves back level. An excellent finish there from Wheeler. London Phoenix came into this game with the second most points in the league, with 355. Scored in the games thus far. Top, of course, Loughborough Lightning, who came in with 478. They're looking, of course, for their 500th basket today. Finish there from underneath the basket as Phoenix give themselves the lead once again. It's been a frustrating start for the home side here. Not finding herself in a position. Williams central, she has to finish and does. Bringing it in Patterson. It's for an angle ball across for Conroy. She picks out a brilliant ball. That's an even better interception from Love. Read that like a children's book. Let's call it the Gruffalo. She stormed in there just to tip it away. Read it fantastically. Be a Phoenix ball. Kramer down the left, skirting back. She might go for it. Oh, that was a long range effort. Not quite from the 3-point line, but far enough attempt from Kramer. of Conroy. Centrally. Look out wide for Wheeler. At an angle. Gets it in. It's a really tidy finish as well. She had a bit of time to eye up her angles there and just decide on where she wanted to put it. And it did so really well. And there's no surprise that she's top of the scoring charts for London Phoenix this season and in this game so far. She's got a 27 points per game average across the season so far. Position to shoot, gets it in. Over the course of the season, she's just got better and better week after week as Robin Love. I mean, if you're an avid watcher of the wheelchair basketball world, you'll know the name Robin Love and you'll know how good the Scotsman can be and has been since she first started playing back in 2014. I mean, it's such a joy to watch her week in, week out, putting the performances that she is doing, and all while raising son Albert along with her teammate Laurie Williams. Balls ricocheted fortuitously here for Kramer, away from the goal, and gets it in brilliantly with her back to the basket, throws it in. That was really nicely done from Kramer. On the left, flirting inside, shooting, just hitting the rim, it bounces back out. Now Maddie Martin scampers away. She's not really had much time on the ball so far today. She does like a shot. I wonder if she might try and creep her way up the field a little bit more in the closing stages of this first quarter. That's a really nice finish from Williams. An acute angle, hits it up high onto the backboard and back down again. A well-executed finish. Now in the centre, Wheeler all alone. Is that in? Not quite. And now again, the speed of the counter-attack is where they make the money. Finding Love. Back to Kramer. She will shoot and she will score. She makes it look so, so easy, does Bo Kramer. And I'm speaking about Robin Love being a joy to watch. So is Kramer. She hasn't flown over for all the games this season for Lightning, which is why points per game average is so high. She's also had a few injury issues this season as well, with her wrist, which of course plays a huge part when competing in basketball. Similarly to darts, the motion of flicking the wrist to make sure that is completely operational to be able to be at your best, which Robin Love is there with a fabulous finish to make it 20-14 and give themselves a little bit of breathing room here. ...15 seconds on the clock left. Chance for Phoenix to bring themselves into touching distance at the end of the first quarter. Around, not wide for Wheeler. She'll shoot and get it in. What a finish. What an effort. He's just in front of the three-point line, so just the 2 points. That was a very entertaining first quarter. Plenty of baskets flying around. Pretty much what we expected, really. And Phoenix will be very happy with how that first half, or first quarter, should I say, has gone. Underway pretty quickly there, actually. I think it caught everyone a little bit unaware, but 2016 is the score between these two sides at the start of that second quarter. Just having a look out on that court to see if any changes have been made for either side. Certainly so. Lindsay Spears has come on to the court, I believe, for Laurie Williams. Correct, sorry, I do apologise. She has come on for, I want to say, Anna Blees, but I'm not 100% sure. Either way, score now reads 22-16. That last basket is the 500th of the season scored by Loughborough Lightning, or should I say 500 points of the season. That's a nice finish just on the end of the Claxon as well. Keep Phoenix in it with a minute gone in the second quarter. Love finding Williams, got a button in the basket, doesn't matter, she can still get them in. Interested to see how long it takes for George Bates, who's just patrolling around his rather small technical area, has to be said, just on the left of your screen there. Interested to see how long it takes him to bring on Siobhan Fitzpatrick, who is back in the squad today for the first time this season. She's been with the club for 3 years, but for the last year she's been suffering from an injury, and she's been really excited as the Brit to be back involved with the action this evening for Loughborough, especially ahead of, firstly, the Paralympic year, secondly, the playoffs coming up, and of course, a couple more games of the season left for Loughborough. It's Jodie Waite there, who's coming on. Go, Siobhan Fitzpatrick. I was just on about how long it would take for George Bates to blink and bring her on. Well, she is just at the back, the ginger hair, number 13. It's Bo Kramer, finds Fitzpatrick. This could be an almighty return! And it is! You'd have been dreaming of that all night long. A fantastic return to the court for Siobhan Fitzpatrick. Yeah. Got a bit of defending to do here. With Conroy just in front. It'll be the first free throws of the game. It's taken a rather long time for those to spring upon us. 7.5 minutes still to go in this second quarter. It will be Amy Conroy to bring her team a little bit closer to Lightning with an excellent finish, it has to be said. She'll go again and get another one in. That was not quite, but almost as good as the first. As an outcome, scampering away to try and extend what at the moment is a 6-point lead, with Williams finding Kramer, finding the back of the basket. It's like clockwork for this team. Once they get their mojo going, there is no stopping them. Conroy, that is lovely. Wasn't too sure whether that was going to drop in or not. Really excellent finish from it. Single leg amputee. Did a first professional photo shoot back in 2023. She spoke about how difficult that was going into it and how she was potentially feeling about it. It was the first one she'd had since being a full leg amputee on the side. She's an incredibly courageous player, both on and off the court. As we get to that first timeout of the second quarter, 30-22 the score to Lightning. But plenty of positives for both sides, really. But plenty for them both to work on. I think that's the most important thing to know. Plenty for them both to work on. And Rally frantically drawing on his board. Away with Brown in possession. Driving forward. She's got plenty of space here. And well, was the referee giving a foul there, perhaps, on Conroy? Took a slight tumble. Side with Conroy, he's missing out. Now Kramer coming forward, central position with Williams on the right side. Let's get towards the back to find Love. Not quite, she'll get another bite at the cherry, evading those challenges and getting it in. Really nicely done. For both sides there. Bo Kramer being replaced by Lucy Robinson. We'll see a return to action for the 24-year-old former footballer. Absolute sports fanatic is Robinson. She broke her hip years ago now. She was on roller skates. She was an avid sports man then and still is now. She'll be looking to get involved straight away as Love finds Fitzpatrick just a little bit out of range for her. The teams will reset back. Finding Love inside for Fitzpatrick. That was straight from the training ground. Out wide to centre, back out wide again. Draw the opposition out. And find yourself in a lovely pocket of space to shoot. Conroy on the ball with 10 seconds left on that clock. They release it quick enough, but not to the outcome that they would have wished. Williams. Running Love, once again, the architect of everything that Loughborough do. It's as simple as that. Finding Robinson, brilliant again. Really good first time finish. But that all came from the patient play from Robin Love, who took her time, found the pass, found the finish. Did Robinson. To the final couple of seconds. Cameron managed it, get it off just as that final second trickled down. Just 12 points separate these two. As we enter the final stages of the second half, second quarter, should I say, as we approach half time. To this right side. Be a free throw here for London Phoenix from the back. Of changes for Loughborough as Clegg Griffiths, the ever-experienced 44-year-old, comes on. Long-range effort. Fortuitously enough for Beth Wheeler. So, looks have to reset as Lightning pounce. Conroy trying to find room to shoot, found the room to pass. Comes back to Conroy, shoots again. Griffiths can't clear, it's far enough away. And those East London Phoenix attacks come to nothing. Side. Trying to find an angle. She'll either have to shoot or pass. Tries to find a pass to Kaylee English. A little bit too much on it there. For the under 25 world champion. We'll have to get back into formation and defend. Conroy. Hits it in. She's getting all the finishes off today. She was the top goal scorer at the 2012 Paralympic Games for Great Britain. They finished seventh overall at those Olympics. She finished top scorer. She's spoken many times about enjoying the speed and aggression of wheelchair basketball. You can certainly see that in the way that she plays. Racing around the court. She's looking to get into the opponent's face. So a couple of baskets that have brought Loughborough Lightning a little bit closer than they probably would have liked to the Phoenix into the final minute and a half of this second quarter. 36-28 the score. Lightning still relatively comfortable with those changes that they have made. Work to do in the last 95 seconds of this second quarter. The final 90 seconds of this second quarter. She's out wide, finds Maddie Martin. Back again. Weaves away brilliantly, finds English. Oh, great finish. Seconds left on the timer. Wheeler will have to go for it. Finds Conroy. She's got to shoot. The Claxon went just after she got it in. Another change this time for London Phoenix. Curran Brown is replaced. Just in front of that three-point line. Back out wide to Love. Really good ball. Back out to Martin. Wide again. Can she finish? Not quite. Comes back to Love. They'll recycle play here with Robinson. Arching back. Scoring superbly. Sideline, making sure that his team know exactly where they should be and what they're doing and what the plan is. Because as it stands, the score is 40 points to 30 at the half-time interval. So just the 10 points separate the two. Plenty of work to do for East London Phoenix, but plenty of positives. Same really story as the first quarter, where they have got a little bit more to do defensively, but going forward they've got no issues whatsoever. And we've got a really tantalising second half on our hands here. Half-time score, Loughborough Lightning 40, East London Phoenix 30.
So, Anna, congratulations on this season so far. It is another title for Lightning, and at the moment, an undefeated season, but a tough test again today against London Phoenix.
Yeah, I mean, we've had some tough games, and we've had some not as tough games, but we don't let up in any of them. We've been playing how we want to play, we've stuck to all the game plans, we've always got stuff we want to work on, so we're just going to keep doing that. I mean, it's nice to have an undefeated season. It just shows that our work that we want to do is working.
And on a personal level, from obviously your point of view, how do you think this season's gone? Are you happy with how you've played? Do you feel like there's certain improvements that you'd like to look upon for next season?
Overall, I think I've had a really good season here. Like, this has been my first season playing for Loughborough, where I've actually been based in Loughborough, because I've go to the university here this year. So it's been really good to just be like around the training environment. I get to train every day, so I've been more like involved within the team. And my development's just shot up because I've been allowed to train every day. My gym like improvements have been crazy. Like, I'm very happy with how the season has gone so far, and even on court, like, I've been learning my roles really well, and I think that I've definitely improved a lot this year. It's been my year.
And then looking ahead to, obviously, this being a Paralympic year, what are your personal hopes for that? Are you hopeful to get selected, and if not, will you be watching from home, and so on?
Yeah, I mean, obviously, like, that has been the aim for like a very long time. Like, this year has been like crunch time. I feel like I've proved myself. I'm really hoping to go to Paris. I think I can do it, but if that's not the case this year, then obviously I'll keep working. Haven't really thought of what I'll do if I don't go, but I will definitely probably head over and watch the girls. But yeah, it's an exciting year.
Fantastic. Well, best of luck for today, and fingers crossed for the Paralympics. So, Anna, congratulations on this season so far. It is another title.
Back then for the second half, two more 10-minute quarters to go. The score's at 40 points to 30. Make that 42 points to 30 with Manny Martin getting the scoring straight off the line inside 10 seconds of the second half. Just slightly there, but well picked up for central position. She may just have to go for it here. She does. Very nearly getting it in, actually. And well recycled there by Brown. Finding Cumroy. He'll go for it once more. Back to Steele. Third attempt. Nick's somewhat frustrated. They've got no points out of that. Here comes Love. Can this be another clinical counter? Quite Kramer that time after coming back off the bench in this second half. Didn't quite find the finish. Conroy. Great finish there from Wheeler. A bit of backspin on it just to fall into the basket pretty much perfectly. Love out wide. Kramer on her own. She arcs back. Pushing the back there. So she'll have an opportunity from this free throw to extend the lead from 10 points to 11. She makes no mistake with the first attempt from her second to make it 44 to 32. More of the same is required. The more of the same is delivered by Kramer. It's a long ball for Wheeler. Trying to pass, trying to find a move. Instead, she just goes on her own. The shot was as good as she probably hoped. Brown. Central position. Over. Back down. Conroy. Finds Brown. Brown has to go for it. And at the end of the klaxon, somehow, it's touched pretty much every part of the basket, apart from the netting. And here come Loughborough. Love to Kramer. To the basket. Light work. At least they make it seem that way. From Loughborough. We are heading for 8 straight wins of an undefeated season. Just the one defeat in the last 3 years now for Loughborough. Finding Love, brilliant pass, brilliant move. Timeout has been called. I think that's the right option there from Adi Rogbemi, the head coach for East London Phoenix. Because this start to the second half and this start to the third quarter, I mean, unfortunately, disastrous for his side. The they've got a lot of work to do if they are to change it around and change their fortunes back onto the right track. Players are ready. We hope you are too as we get up back off and underway following that timeout. Phoenix in possession with Conroy. She comes forward. Into the space and gets it in. To Williams, just like that, from back to front. Look out wide, clock ticking, finish. Though from the wide man there, Debbie Steele, number 7, keeping the hopes alive for her side. Williams looking to destroy those hopes, pushing the back there on her. Substitution for Loughborough Lightning. And a Blease comes on to replace Robin Love. Spoke with Blease before the game. Just about how she's feeling ahead of the Paralympics. She's hoping to be selected for Paris 2024. The form this season would suggest that that is the case. It's her first full season that she's been actually living here in Loughborough, now that she's studying here. She'll be relatively pleased with that cameo appearance off the bench with an immediate point from her first touch. It's not a bad way to introduce yourself. There's Wheeler. Holds firm. Just White lurking. Wide to the centre, goes for the long range effort from the 3-point line, just setting the rim. That would have been delightful if that had made the basket. Not quite this time. Kramer looking for space. She's got all of the space, and when you give someone with her quality with that much time, that much room, essentially stand off them far too much. Only one way that is going, and he's into the back of the basket from the world champion from the Netherlands. Just the 5 seconds left. Wheeler might just have to go for this into the final second, gives it away straight to Kramer, and now come Lightning. Pulsating attack down the left. Such pace from Kramer. Couldn't quite get the finish off. Finish there from the number six, Sophie Patterson. The former GB athlete, European bronze medalist, puts herself on the score sheet for this evening's game as Kramer goes for a long range effort, just hits the underside of the backboard and bounces away to Phoenix possession as they trail 54 points to 38. Kramer. He's making a nice darting move down the right, back into Kramer. Mel Martin back out wide. Williams to Martin. We'll get another bite at it. Will they get a third? Quite, really good interception there from Jody Waite, the 20-year-old Irishman. Phoenix to give themselves still a bit of hope. Only the 14 points separate the two as we enter the final 2.5 minutes of this third quarter. Loughborough have suffered slightly since Robin Love's departure from the court. And here's her partner, Laurie Williams, finding Kramer. Just hits the end of the basket. Well, pretty short celebrations there from the Sound and PA team as they believe that it had gone in, but not quite from Bo Kramer. She'd hit the rim. Hitting the rim at the other end there, London Phoenix. And can Kramer find an avenue once again here down the right? Going inwards, back out wide to left. Kramer just hitting the rim again, comes back out to Williams. Still time, Anna Please sets her sights. Kramer, brilliant interception from Conroy. Charging in there to claim the ball. Conroy still. On the wide left. Martin comes away now. Down the right. Kramer. Martin's at the back. Can she find her? Yes, she can. Well, not quite, actually. That's a really interesting interception there from Sophie Patterson. She just flicked out her left arm. Just a flick it away from her, man. With a minute and 10 seconds to go of this third quarter. Timeout has been called by Loughborough Lightning's George Bates. And I think that's the right thing to do. While they do still lead by 54 points to 14, still have that 14-point gap. Phoenix have certainly brought themselves back into it in the last few minutes. timeout is over. The time is now for these two sides to get back on the court. Battle their way through only for the next 70 seconds. And of course, one more quarter coming your way live here on YouTube. Kramer. That is the kind of response George Bates would have wanted. Really fantastic play. Nothing overzealous, just got it out wide, flicked it in. Really wanting to quite that Katy Perry song, but swish, swish, flick. Another one in the basket. Final 30 seconds of this quarter. Kramer has just got such ridiculous acceleration going forward. Brilliant control of the chair. And getting it in. That is some finish. And some run there from Kramer. She was just upheld slightly. And she kept the balance, got the finish, which is why she has this free throw now to extend the lead. And she does so brilliantly. Just the 1 point added on there, 59 points to 40. And that timeout call from Loughborough Lightning has turned into a fantastic one at that. Frustration there for Adia Ragbemic. Speaking with the officials. Wheeler's got a shoot, does, just evades the basket. And you just have those 22 seconds once you get the ball to go from one end of the field to the other and release your shot. If you release your shot and it comes back to you, time starts again. Wheeler did it there. And now just the 1 second left, a cross-court shot there. I'll tell you what, that was actually not that far away. At the end of the third quarter, the score reads Loughborough Lightning 59, London Phoenix 40.
That's the end of the third quarter. The score, Loughborough Lightning 59, East London Phoenix 40.
Underway then for this final quarter. Will be a free throw situation inside the opening 6 seconds of this final stage of the game. And it will be Beth Wheeler over it. also plays for the London Titans and the former GB athlete. Got herself another point to add to her tally, not just for this season, but of course in the game. Another fine finish. Tell you what, she'll go for a third one here. Make it a hat-trick of perfect three throws. And does so fantastically well for her side. Down the right they'll get. We have Kramer. Not wide. Come back on the inside. That's a great ball for Love, who's just come back off the bench. Can she make an instant return? An instant impact. Neither her or Kramer could finish that time. Now East London Phoenix go forward. Love. Central position. And Phoenix coming forward. Wheeler. She's got an option to her left. Doesn't use it. She's now out wide on her own. Isolated. Finds a pass inwards. Kramer there charging in with a great interception and block. Around back out again, out wide, be thrown in, hits the edge of the rim, back to Kramer, arching back, and she couldn't finish that time. That's a rarity. Soak that one in. You're not likely to see that more than twice in a game. Finish there from London Phoenix, who've got a pretty decent fourth quarter here. They still trail, but Loughborough certainly needs to get a few more points on the board for them to feel comfortable going into the final 8 minutes. Love out wide. And in the corner. Out due to the whistle on Orny gone. Love to the final 7 seconds they've got of the ball. Love goes for it, finishes it. I don't know why there's even a slight hint of surprise in my voice. It's an excellent finish from someone who's just been ridiculously consistent in this game and across the season. Great finish there. Took so. Pressure increases. Just the 14 points separate them. Make that 16. Had to wait there. not just one bite at the cherry, not just two, three overall for Loughborough Lightning there to get those points. Now a timeout is called before that free throw is taken by Bo Kramer. So just under 7 minutes to go. Score 61-47. Have now been added on that Kramer just got a few moments ago. 63-47 the score, 16 points clear in front, and a chance now to make it 17 in front from this free throw. Excellently done by Kramer, makes it 64 points for her side. And now Wheeler comes away, and we've already heard Lightning got so many players back in those defensive positions. Angling her out wide, Wheeler. She may just have to go for the shot here. Indeed, she does. Frick says foul there on the man. It's going to be a free throw situation for East London Phoenix this time, with Wheeler over it. Nice finish there from Wheeler. Well, I said earlier that she averages 27 points per game. You can actually see why now. Ridiculously efficient with any... well, I was going to say with any opportunities that come our way. I spoke a little bit too soon there. She missed that one. Yeah, I think the point still remains. She's very, very consistent with what she does. Those free throws or opportunities that she creates herself on is passed from, of course, her teammates. Here come Phoenix, Conroy, Wheeler. Great pass inwards. Can they finish it? We'll get another chance on another maybe. White drop down. Kramer is back up, which is great to see. Right shot there from Conroy. Back into the arms of Loughborough Lightning as they come forward. Love. Nice. Dip one way and then the other. Shot comes in, cleared away. Phoenix haven't given up yet. They never would. They've got that, I'm going to say, die attitude. From the back. Yes,
back to Love. I felt like asleep. Skirts out wide. Foot comes in. It's just what she does. Really is magic from Robin Love. And Phoenix ball from the back as they start to come forward now with Conroy. And left. Takes a shot off. Gets it in. Cute angle. Oh, it's brilliant. Really, really nicely done. They bring up their points tally to 21 ahead of their opposition with 4 minutes remaining. Substitutions now for Loughborough Lightning and one for East London Phoenix. Come Brown coming back on. Eddie Martin also back on the field, back on the court for Loughborough Lightning. Once again, the architect just floats in with the pace and then finds the pass to Kramer. They just make it look so easy. Like a knife through butter, a hot knife through butter. Made of lava through butter. I'm sure you get the picture. It just is such a joy to watch them, but they just make it so easy, the way they just creep forward and have these potent attacks. Once again, good to see there that I believe that is Sophie Patterson back on to her wheels. Such a ferocious sport. I mentioned earlier that Amy Conroy said that she enjoys the speed and aggression of the sport. I think that says it all, really. It's such a fast sport, especially when, you know, you've got a chair flying at you at, you know, 15 miles an hour, 10 miles an hour. They do come at you with some speed. I mean, you just have to have a look at Bo Kramer when she's charging down one of the wings, either left or right. She just comes at them with such speed, and if that does clatter into you, it is going to hurt. That is an awesome finish from Kramer. Don't think it has counted. As she was just falling over slightly, she somehow managed to release that from her grasp, find the angle and get it in. There's another timeout is called with just 3 minutes left of this fourth quarter. Well, we're back underway then, or about to be, for the final 2 minutes and 57 seconds of this penultimate home game of the season for Loughborough Lightning. They're back in action once again on the 5th of May in their final game of the regular season. This is East London Phoenix's last game of the season. Last home game was last time out. They won by 91 points to 42 against the Cardiff Met Archers down in London. There's Loughborough last time out away in Wolverhampton, won up by 76 points to 26. They're on course to get more than 76 points today against a position that are just below them in the league. That's 73 points at the moment, and about 20 seconds to try and get a few more points on the board. They've scored over 250 baskets now this season. It's been another prolific campaign from them. Another excellent display all round from them, not just in this game, but every game, week in, week out. East London Phoenix have given it their all today, but it's clear they still need a couple of extra additions to this side to really make them title challengers. Just went flying in there. It's a good pass from Robin Love. Just sort of got sandwiched there by Curran Brown. It will be a free throw situation. It's Butler and Williams a mile away with that yellow chair. We'll be here to send this free throw in. Doesn't quite get the finish that she'd have been hoping for. That time she doesn't either. She's not known for her basket scoring prowess in her defence, but she'll still be disappointed not to finish either of those. As will you ever expect Loughborough crowd. Love, you can now dribble away down the left, chance to extend the scoring, finds a pass for Claire Griffiths, not quite, the basketball veteran there. So well to go from one end of the court to the other. Steal. Look again. It's a long range shot. Love. Griffiths, recycled play, back inside, back out wide for Love. Can she finish? She can. It's a great finish as well from Holly Lowndes, the 19-year-old. Not her most impactful game this week, but nice to get a finish nevertheless. So the final 10 seconds we go. Curran Brown, out wide, steal. The final 5 seconds of the game, a free throw situation. Oh, Debbie Steele. Doesn't get the first one in. But with her second attempt, she makes it 49 points to 75. With 5 seconds left. Griffiths tries a long ball. And that is that. On a relatively comfortable evening overall for Loughborough Lightning against an East London Phoenix side we all expect a little bit more of. They were a little bit late getting here, a few travel issues, so maybe that played a part with their preparation for the game, but either way, it is East London Phoenix who have lost by 49 points to 75 against the league leaders and league winners, Loughborough Lightning. It was fantastic to see Bo Kramer on her return to the side. The 24-year-old really was a dangerous player on the court for Lightning. Alongside, of course, Robin Love, who, once again, the captain, was just ever-present and ever the difference maker for her side. Again then, your full-time score, Loughborough Lightning 75, East London Phoenix 49. The next time Lightning are in action here will be on the 5th of May as they'll be lifting the title following a fantastic season, no matter what happens in that final game. But they'll be hoping to go 9-9 for the second successive season. Well, from us all here at Loughborough University, the Netball and Badminton Centre, and from myself, Elliot Stoddale, thank you ever so much for joining us, and we do hope to have you again here soon in the future.
Loughborough Lightning have one more game left in the season before May, and that is here at home.